Not sure how to pronounce this one. It's peridot, 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 but either way, it's a rather interesting stone. So as you can see from the thumbnail in the picture there, this stone, which I'm not going to try to pronounce again, is rather pretty. It's very, very green. So I got some notes. We're going to go over those. So it's associated with the solar plexus and heart chakras. It's the birthstone for August. Its zodiac signs is Gemini, Leo, Virgo, Scorpio, and Sagittarius. And its planet is Mercury. Its element is Earth. Rather interesting that Mercury is more associated with air and its element is Earth, but hey. So the typical colors are olive green, like a bottle-ish green, or a yellowish green. It's called the extreme gem, which I think is really interesting. It's the gem form of olivine, which is made of magnesium iron silicate. It's part of the forstalite, phaolite family of minerals. Really hard things to pronounce sometimes. It's also called true topaz. It was actually first called Topazios after an island in the Red Sea, which was owned by the Egyptians. I think it's now called St. John's Island. And the Egyptians actually owned that for 3.5 centuries. So this stone itself, it's good for balancing the cycles of life, like menstruation and sleep. It's good for those who want to quit smoking. It's a good stone for a wounded healer. And by that, I mean it can help you with understanding like any traumas and difficulties that you went through, what the gifts are from those things. Back to the notes here. So it's good for dealing with emotional problems that can affect the physical body, like depression, like how depression can actually affect your own metabolism and even give you body aches and pains and things like that. It'll bring peaceful sleep. It's good for presentations and in the spotlight situations like stage fright, things like that. So it's a good stone for introverts to have if they have to do things out in the open. So it also balances the endocrine system. It benefits those with nearsightedness and astigmatism. Nearsightedness? Yeah, that's me. Yes, please. It can also heal ulcers. It can help bring clarity of thought. So if you find that you have like a foggy mind sometimes, it helps with that. It can bolster independence. So if you need to be more of a stand-on-your-own kind of person, it's good. This is a good stone for you. It allows assertiveness without aggressiveness, because a lot of times when we are assertive, sometimes we can take it over the top, and we can really be mean when we are just trying to like stand on our ground and have our boundaries and things like that. It's the only other gem, along with diamonds, that are formed in molten rock under high pressure. So it's really interesting that both diamonds and this one are formed by the same processes, and it's the only two that, as far as my research, that we know of that it is. So it can be found in meteorites too, which is really cool, which means it can come from way deep in the earth and way out there in outer space, right? It's one of the only stones that forms in only one color. It's protective stone. It banishes darkness and negativity. It can help it manifest abundance. It's good for healing, renewal, purification, rebirth, growth, relaxation, comfort, intuition. It's a cleansing stone. It can release toxins. It can fight negative emotions like jealousy, resentment, spite, bitterness, irritation, hatred, and greed. And it also fights stress, anger, and feelings of guilt. So this thing gets rid of anything negative. Period. Anything negative. And it can boost confidence and assertiveness. Allows you to take responsibility for things. Boost the immune system and metabolism. It fights problems in the heart, it's the lungs, the thymus, the gallbladder, the spleen, intestines, and it can also benefit hypochondriacs and those with bipolar disorder. So clearly this stone gets rid of anything negative. It brings balance into things. It can help purify things, and it can really help you stand on your own 2 feet and get done what needs to get done. So once again, I don't have a specimen of this one, but it's a rather interesting stone that I might have to pick up for myself. So let me know what you think about this or request a stone down below, and I'll see you in the next vid. Good hunting. Thanks for watching my video. So if you want to check out my playlists, I have, among others, the Simon Necronomicon, the Tree of Life, General Magic, Tulpomancy, a playlist on my books, the Elements, Stones, the Theories That Govern Magic, and the Gods and Goddesses of Mesopotamia. If you want to check out my books on Amazon, I have Creating Consciousness, Magical Mechanics, Magical Theater, Handy Sigil Magic, Magical Movement, which is an update and expansion upon Handy Sigil Magic, Magical Mastery, which is a combination masterwork of Magical Theater and Magical Mechanics, and The Guide to the Spheres and Beyond. You can also find me on Facebook at MagicologyYT. You can email me at priestofthenecro@gmail.com, and you can even check out my Instagram, which is Magicology. And good hunting.